Hello everyone, James Migues with ListaHouse.com, real estate and property management. Don't forget, listings is what we do, so list your house with ListaHouse. All right, to the point. What to talk about? I wasn't sure what to talk about, but I decided that I'm going to talk about what's going on in the market right now. Realtors are lost, buyers are lost, sellers don't know what to do. Unfortunately, that is the situation. Thank you to this NAR settlement that just got implemented a few weeks ago. It's bad. I honestly do not agree with it. I think it's bad for the consumer, especially the buyer. Why? Well, there's a lot of situations, a lot of reasons why. I can maybe talk about it in another video, but not in this time. But right now, what I basically want to say is talk to the buyers. If you are a buyer, get yourself represented by a buyer's broker. The situation with this is that now you as a buyer will have to sign a contract with the buyer's broker, which is fine, I agree with that. But the part that I kind of find a little bit difficult to understand why they're doing it like that is that now they're trying to get the buyer to pay for the buyer's broker commission or a compensation, whatever you want to call it. It's the same stuff, same situation. I think that's wrong because buyers, one, are always trying to get money from wherever they can to be able to round up enough money to be able to buy themselves the best home that they can, as they should. Now, this settlement is asking them to, you know what, now you got to go out and scrounge up another $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 to be able to get a realtor to represent you. They're not gonna do that. So what's gonna happen, they're gonna go out on their own. They go out on their own, that's like grabbing someone that don't know how to swim and throwing them in the middle of the ocean and say, survive, swim. It's not gonna happen. They're gonna drown. This business is not as easy as people think. It's not about us driving around town showing pretty houses. I wish it was like that, but it's not. There's a lot of stuff behind the scenes that most people don't see. A good agent will not allow their buyer or their seller to deal with the troubles. We deal with the troubles. Unless something comes up, then we say, hey, Mr. Buyer, Mr. Seller, there's a problem. We need to resolve this. But there's a lot of other things that we can do to resolve it, and the buyer or the seller does it. No. Which then makes the transaction very smooth. So that's why a lot of people think we don't do anything. No, we work harder than what you expect. Or think, I mean, you expect a lot, but you don't know what we do. So anyway, as a buyer, please, I'm telling you, please hire a buyer's broker to represent you. Don't worry about how they're gonna get paid. There's always ways to get around it. And as a seller, I am sure most sellers will realize that it is good and smart to be able to offer a compensation to the listing agent, because whatever the listing agent does, it's a deal. Listing agent will deal with the seller. They will negotiate their fee as they always have. And as a listing agent, as myself, I then turn around and offer the buyer's broker, said, hey, I'll split my commission with you if you bring me a buyer. That is most likely what will continue happening. That's what's been going on for the last 40 years or so. I don't remember the exact date when it was implemented, but they did that to protect the buyer. I feel now we're going backwards. They keep saying, oh, it's transparent. BS. My opinion on that is BS, because it's not transparent anymore. Everybody knew what was going on. Everybody knew what was getting paid. Now, nobody knows. It's just, I'm not going to get into it. But anyway, so as a buyer, I don't agree with it. As a buyer, get yourself represented, talk to your agent, figure out a way how to make this possible for you to get represented. There's always a way. The buyers, most likely a good listing agent, will talk to their seller and highly recommend. I think you should definitely get the commission done. You get the commission. We as listing agent will turn around and share it with the buyer's broker. That way the deal will go smoother and less possibility that deal will die, which happens from time to time. So I think you really, as a buyer, you need to think about that. And as a seller, think about that as well. Now, the other thing I want to talk about is the buyers. A lot of buyers right now are waiting for this interest rates to go down. Fine, that's good. That's a good idea. But is it? You got to think about simple supply and demand. Right now, there's a lot of buyers that are just sitting and waiting, not knowing what to do, or basically waiting to see if the interest rates will go down, which they can, and that's maybe it's a good idea, but is it really? I don't know. Because if the interest rates go down, which they should, a whole bunch of buyers, a big wave of buyers would come into the market. What's the simple supply and demand rule or law, whatever you want to call it? Well, when there's a lot of demand, supply, the prices will go up. So prices are already high in the first place. Once you get this big wave of buyers coming in to buy, price is not going to go down. Price is going to go up. So it may be wiser to buy it now instead of waiting for later. You'll save money on your monthly payment because the interest rate down. But then again, if the prices of the house is going down, which is still going up, you're going to end up paying more anyway. So it's probably wiser if you buy now at the interest rate the best interest rate that you can find now, and then 2-3 years down the road, when the interest rates are really lower or when they really go down, then do a refinance. You have your house, and all you can do is refinance, and then you lower your monthly payment. The whole thing is getting the house that you want at the price that you want. If you wait, prices are going to probably go up. So be aware of that. Be careful with that. And again, like I was saying, get yourself represented with a buyer's broker. It's good for everybody. You know, for you as the buyer, it's good for the deal, for the transaction, and a good buyer's broker will figure things out for you so that you don't have to pay them and put money out of your pocket or an extra $5, $10, $15,000 to take care of that. They will talk to the list. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of listing agents. We are. All my customers are still going to have to pay. If they want our service, our premium service with everything and the years of experience that we have, they're going to still have to pay us the fee that we represent and what we do, because we're going to give part of that. I'm going to share part of my commission with the buyer's agent. I don't want to deal with buyers with no representation, because all that's going to do is stress the deal, especially when a buyer has no clue what to do. How's the buyer going to send the contract? They don't know how to write the first contract. So that's a problem. So think about that. As a buyer, get yourself represented by a buyer's broker. You need to do that for yourself, for your family, for the money that you're going to be investing, and you have a less probability that you will lose it. Because if you don't do things right, you will lose your deposit. So anyway, that's it for now. We'll talk soon. Take care. Bye.